Your Excellencies, it should not be lost on anyone that the minerals on which the world depends to move industry and manufacturing are mostly available in Africa. And yet we, who own these fundamental resources by birthright, have remained poor, whilst our minerals have brought vast wealth to nations and peoples outside our continent. It is worth pointing out also that not only do we not get a fair share of the wealth once extracted, our lands, our environment, our oceans are often left devastated by the process, and the competition to gain control over these minerals has often led to insecurity in our countries. I do not seek to blame outsiders for our problems, but since we are being asked to find multilateral solutions, I believe it is worth pointing out that unfairness in the economic order undermines the fight against poverty. Indeed, the flight of capital is continuing the foreign exploitation of Africa, represented by colonialism and imperialism. The report of the panel, chaired by the highly respected former South African president, Thabo Mbeki, on the illicit flow of funds from Africa, has raised the lid on what many had always suspected, but did not have the figures to support. According to that report, Africa is losing annually more than $50 billion United States dollars through illicit financial outflows. Collaboration is certainly needed amongst the nations of the world to stop this rape of Africa. The African Continental Free Trade Area, which recently came into effect and whose secretariat Ghana has the honor of hosting, is a major collective effort by Africa to get to grips with mastery of her own development. It will be the world's largest free trade area since the formation of the World Trade Organization and will provide the vehicle for us to trade better among ourselves, offer an opportunity to exploit our abundant wealth and resources for the benefit of our peoples and give us protection in how to deal with other trading blocs. Mr. President, the fight to eradicate poverty is intrinsically linked to quality education, the second part of the problems identified for special attention during this General Assembly meeting. Wherever quality education is available, there's usually prosperity. Throughout the ages, education has been the most equitable source of providing opportunities and has provided the fastest and most reliable route out of poverty. The image that has stayed with me since I was 25 years old and which still brings me true awe and wonder is that picture of the Earth taken from the vantage point the astronauts had, which showed clearly the truth of the one world that we inhabit. We could try to delineate our borders more clearly. We could make clearer distinctions on the basis of color, race, language, and creed. That picture tells us the natural path is to be inclusive. This in no way is meant to paper over the many difficulties we have in our part of the world that we have to overcome, or to suggest that because some parts of the world are developed and prosperous, we can pretend all is well with us as well. In my part of the world, we do not argue over what constitutes poverty. We know it, we live with it, feel it, and it is a daily reality. As the old saying goes, birds sing not because they have answers, but because they have songs. There might not be any one answer to the theme of this 74th General Assembly, but the hope is that the discussions point us to the possibility of a new world in which collaboration between the nations and peoples is on such a scale that one can dream of and achieve a sustainably prosperous world. I thank you for your attention.